I want to move on to what happened to one of your colleagues this week when Al Franken decided to resign. I want to play for you something that was sort of a common refrain among quite a few conservatives. Here's Newt Gingrich.
And what you saw today was a lynch mob. Let's not have due process. Let's not ask anybody any questions. Let's not have any chance to have a hearing. Let's just lynch him.
Al Franken wanted the Ethics Committee to take a look first before he made any decisions. Bob Menendez is in the midst of an Ethics Committee probe. Why should Bob Menendez be given time in front of the Ethics Committee before you guys as Democrats decide his fate versus Al Franken?
Well, Bob Menendez, as you know, underwent a lengthy trial. There was a hung jury. He was not convicted of anything.
He may be retried, for what it's worth.
Well, he may be, but that's where we are today. I think in terms of Al Franken, what you have, and Al Franken is a friend of mine and I think has been a very good senator for Minnesota. But what you have is a situation where Senator Franken acknowledged wrongdoing on several occasions, inappropriate behavior. And he felt that the appropriate thing to do was to offer his resignation. I think what the absurdity is...
He didn't think, I'll be honest with you, Senator, he didn't sound like somebody who thought it was appropriate. He sounded like somebody who was being forced to resign. He wasn't being
forced. Well, I don't know that you know what was in Al Franken's mind. But the point is that we have the absurdity now of a president of the United States who basically says on a tape that everybody in this country has seen his pride, in a sense, in assaulting women. And he has not apologized for that. And he has, you know, not offered his resignation. So I think that's the absurdity. But I think in terms of what Gingrich was saying, there needs to be a due process. There needs to be a differentiation between somebody who pats somebody on the backside and somebody who commits terrible acts against women. And furthermore, what we need in this country, and this whole debate discussion is bringing this up, we need a cultural revolution. Mm-hmm. Because it's not just famous people who are harassing women. There are people all over this country, women who are working in restaurants, who are being harassed every single day. We need to change the culture of how we treat women on the job.
I want to ask you about the issue of impeachment. Here is Tom Steyer. He's a billionaire activist, may run for the U.S. Senate himself in California. He's been running these ads nationwide. Let me play a clip.
He's brought us to the brink of nuclear war, obstructed justice at the FBI, and in direct violation of the Constitution, he's taken money from foreign governments and threatened to shut down news organizations that report the truth. If that isn't a case for impeaching and removing a dangerous president, then what has our government become?
Look, you just established you want him to resign, but the
no,
U.S.
what I
Congress,
just said, what I no, just, oh, Chuck, Chuck, yeah. What I just said is Al Franken felt it proper for him to resign. Here you have a president who has been accused by many women of assault, who says on a tape that he assaulted women. He might want to think about doing the same.
All right. No, but understandable. But let me go to this impeachment question here. Is Tom Steyer right that it's time to look at that option? There was already a House vote this week. Many Democrats weren't ready to get on that bandwagon yet. Where are you on this issue?
I think there is a process that has to be followed. I think Mr. Mueller is doing a very good job on his investigation. And if Mueller brings forth the clear evidence that there was collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians, I think you have grounds for impeachment. But I think jumping the gun does nobody any good. You have to bring the American people onto this issue. You don't want to make it into a partisan issue. If we're going to go forward with impeachment, I want the American people clearly to understand why that is the case, why it makes sense, why it's the right thing to do. I don't think we're there right now. That's what the Mueller investigation is all about. And by the way, I am deeply offended by Republican efforts to try to discredit Mr. Mueller. When he was FBI director, he was a great guy. Now that he's doing his job here, Republicans don't like him. I think that's really unfair.
That is an issue we are actually going to be diving into later in this show. Senator Sanders, as always, sir, thank you for coming on and sharing your views. I appreciate it.